What's in a byte? Kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, terabyte, petabyte, exabyte, zettabyte, and yottabyte. Hi, my name is Emily, and this is Blink Pop Shift. Let's start small. What's the smallest program ever written? Well, it depends on how you define program, but there are some pretty tiny Linux executables out there. True.asm is a standalone binary gate that passes back a 1, 1, 1, or 0 depending on if you name it true or false. And it's a minuscule 45 bytes wrapper and all. That's an impressive feat, but it's not much to look at. But if we step up to a few kilobytes, the demo scene can provide some of the smallest audiovisuals, smallest audiovisuals ever made. Back in the early days of 8 and 16-bit computers, software cracking was all the rage, and crackers liked to add their own little flair to the startup of programs that they'd help liberate. These became known as demos, and to this day, demo sceners are creating custom tools to pack even more code into the 4 kilobyte limit. 4 kilobyte. This procedurally generated landscape of fractal, titled with a collection of letters I'm not gonna embarrass myself by trying to pronounce, was made by demo scene pacifist and won first place at Revision, a huge demo scene competition held in Germany in 2012. 4 kilobytes. 4 kilobytes. 4 kilobytes. That's about the same number of bits we use today to store the script for this video. Just the letters, mind you. No formatting or readable file type, just the characters. Even its own YouTube video is larger than the demo itself. 4 kilobytes. So we can crunch an amazing amount of code into a very small space, but what about the other extreme? As of now, the largest photo ever made was this panorama of London, which measures in at a behemoth 320 gigapixels. The largest single torrent file? A 746 gigabyte collection of all of the 2010 World Cup soccer matches. With file sizes like that, it shouldn't be all that surprising that from just 2011 to 2012, there was a 48% increase in overall data, bringing our worldwide total to 2.7 zettabytes. Zeta with a Z. That's 2.7 followed by 21 zeros. And by 2020, projections suggest that we will be swimming in a 35 zettabyte world. What is all of it? Well, currently 90% of the world's data is unstructured. Digital video, audio files, images, games, and other media that pose a huge challenge to search and retrieval. A challenge which, just in case you missed it, we talked about in this video on why search sucks and what we're doing to fix it. 35 zettabytes seems like a lot, but how much data do I contain? With its 6 × 10⁹ base pairs and 4 base pairs per 8-bit byte, the information storage capacity of the human genome is about 1.5 gigabytes. Not much. But if my whole body with its 100 trillion cells were read-write, then I am made of 150 zettabytes of highly redundant self-organizing information. So where are we gonna put it all? Sure, Moore's law, the observation that the number of transistors on integrated circuits doubles about every 2 years, might get all the press, but remember this little atom scale animation done by IBM last year? The technology that made this possible is being used to push current limits of digital data concentration. Much like we want to pack more and more computation into a smaller and smaller area, similar patterns of improvement are happening in bit storage as well. And all those improvements in computation mean that access is easier than storage. It's why the cloud has become an ever more ubiquitous feature, and why companies like Seagate are working hard at inventing things like shingled magnetic recording to break current capacity barriers. We've made so much progress, in fact, that 5 terabyte drives will be available this year. 5 terabytes! To put that in perspective, IBM's Watson won Jeopardy accessing just 4 terabytes of data. So what can we do with all this new capacity? Make art where bigger is always better, of course. Take Black MIDI. Black MIDI is a subgenre of electronic music so dense with notes that images of the music when notated on standard sheet look almost redacted. This information density makes for some amazing listening. And beyond just making fantastically complex maximalist music, blackers compete to make compositions with higher and higher note counts. The current top-breaking song is an arrangement of Bad Apple by Gnaeus featuring 280 billion notes. Billions and billions. So many, in fact, that the music is completely unplayable by current computers. The songs that can be played are turned over to a Guitar Hero-esque learn-to-play piano simulation software. Some songs play through fine, but as the note counts grow, eventually these songs outstrip the software's capacity. And this is where Black MIDI gets really fun. You get to watch the system break down, which brings to the forefront that oh so often overlooked of instruments, software. If you want to know more about the art of the glitched, check out Idea Channel's video on the topic. But suffice it to say, because the malfunction isn't binary, either working or blue screen, these artists are bringing Broken is Beautiful out of the nostalgic past and giving us a peek into our ever faster and data dense machines. But what do you think? How will rising storage capacities affect unstructured data online? And do you know any artists who are up to the challenge of a 5 terabyte drive? You can find me at Emily Eifler, and as always, thank you for watching and get curious.
Is the show really over?
Kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte? Damn it. Kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, terabyte, exabyte? Fuck. Kilobyte, exabyte? No. Kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, terabyte, exabyte, petabyte, zettabyte, yottabyte. Except for it's petabyte, exabyte. Kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, terabyte, petabyte, zettabyte. Ugh. So hard.